Assassin's Creed Mirage is a game riddled with holes, but there is some good in it. At first, it's just another Assassin's Creed game made by Ubisoft, obviously, but it was also meant to be a DLC for Valhalla, but turned into a full game. The ups for it, you get to explore Basim's life and how he became an assassin. That is good because it brings in from when Basim was first introduced to now, and you kind of get to see why he became one, how he progresses, and so on. The problem is, it is very quick in doing this. It's not like, let's have some fleshing out of his early life to now, or explain why he's becoming one. It's just, okay, we're gonna do this mission, learn this thing, okay, now let's take this, and oh, boom, now you're an assassin. It was way too quick-paced. And in kind of a spoiler, in one of the first missions, you have to steal an item from, obviously, the leader of that city. But the problem is, in doing this, Basim is extremely overreactionary in what happens, and just really dumb, in my opinion, of it. It could have been way better. They progressed the story way too quickly. Could have been slower to the build-up and just been a better overall experience. Personally, it just seems childish in the reactionary from him. And another thing, I do like that they brought back the tools where you have smoke bomb, a noisemaker in this one where it obviously makes noise, you have a throwing knife, and you also have the sleep dart, which is definitely useful. The problem is, it's not that great. It's just continuously adding more stuff that can only be upgraded somewhat, and then you're done. And in conjunction with this, around the map, you have obviously your craftsmen that can help with upgrading this. But you have to go to chests, find all the items you need for it, and then you have to craft it. So, just like Valhalla, you have to pinpoint what you want to upgrade versus another, which is a little annoying. And another thing that I think can go for it is that you learn the skills at a weird time while you also have to try and live during the beginning of it, which is kind of weird. It doesn't say, okay, let's press this button to do this, this button to do that. No, we're just going to throw you in the middle of a fort for one of the main missions to start off with, and then we're going to be like, okay, run, don't die. And maybe you'll learn some of these moves along the way. Personally, I think there should have been more of that at the beginning of trying to learn moves and just dodging, slicing, and blocking or evading. It doesn't do that, which is a shame. I do wish, because they said they were bringing back to the roots, which somewhat yes, but also no, they should have brought back the throwing the coins to have a distraction. They did bring back the sitting on a bench to blend in, or being around other people to blend in, which is pretty good. Brings back to the old type of Assassin's Creed, which I liked. But I do think they should have brought back the throwing the coins to have people just mob around it to try and get it, therefore causing distraction and you to get away. I think they should have done that. They didn't, but Oh well. Another thing I think could have been better is the parkour mechanic. Since they brought it back to the old time, they essentially brought back the old mechanic of parkour. But it became so slow and clunky, like the old one. I think they should have kept it more like Assassin's Creed Odyssey, Valhalla, where it's a lot more smooth, where instead of stopping on one point for like half a second, you just continuously go and actually have a smooth transition versus essentially sticking to it like glue is on your shoe and then jumping to the next spot. And that kind of ruins the fluidity of it. After that, kind of goes downhill. There's just the same types of enemies everywhere you go. There's an archer, there's a heavy guy, and then there's melee people. That's it. Maybe your bosses that you'll find, but other than that, just repetitive for the same ones. There aren't like a bunch of enemies, which should have been helpful because then you'd be trying to actually learn the game more, be more invested, trying to perform better in it, to live essentially, and either get away or attack all the enemies and trying to not die, essentially. Another thing I very much believe they need to work on in it is the animation. First hour I played, I noticed it was way below par, to say the least. I would recommend that Ubisoft have a major update for the graphics, because on mine, even in 4K, it was bad. I had multiple stutters. The characters looked either off color for what I was doing, or they were just making weird movements that made no sense. One of the characters looked gray, while another one looked like black as night, which made no sense. And then your character, Basim, just, I don't get the coloring of this. It's just so off for every single thing. And another thing is they also reuse voice lines from previous Assassin's Creed, so they were just cutting the budget, essentially, trying to get as much as they could out of it while also reusing old lines to seem like they were doing something, when in reality they were just half-assing it. And you actually hear one of the little kids in the main area when you first start the game has a voice from Assassin's Creed Odyssey. As far as I know, I don't think they did it with anybody else, but I could be wrong. But it just seems like they cut so many corners in what they were doing. The animation in one of the parts where you're with Rashaan and just trying to go back to the city, way below par, in my opinion. It seems really rushed in certain parts and just doesn't seem like it's worth it to me. I don't get how they made this a game. I really don't. They should have just made it another DLC, which it was going to be for Valhalla. But they decided to make it a game and charge more money than what it's worth. Personally, I think this game is worth maybe $30, $40 at the absolute most. But if you want to buy it, go for it. Because it's another Assassin's Creed, a bunch of people will buy it. But I think you should save your money on this game and buy an either older Assassin's Creed game or buy another game entirely. Because in my opinion, I give this a 3 out of 10. That could change in the future if they actually help improve the quality of life in it. But so far right now, I just do not think this is worth your time and money. Because they clearly have not put their time and money into this and are just essentially scamming you. So I say, don't buy it. Buy a different game and hope you have better time with those than this game, because I can't play it anymore. I tried, just couldn't.